lifestyle changes can be really helpful, but what if those aren't enough? In many cases, if your blood sugar is still difficult to control after you've changed your diet or increased the amount of exercise you get, it may be time to start a medication. There are two main types of diabetes, so not all diabetes medications work for all patients. Patients with type 1 diabetes, the main issue here is that their body doesn't do a very good job producing enough insulin. And so many times the medication they need to take are medications that replace the insulin. And insulin usually needs to be injected. In type 2 diabetes, many times this is a disease that runs in families. And the problem here is that the body doesn't do a very good job responding to insulin, or the body produces too much glucose, which is a type of sugar that raises your blood sugar levels. And in type 2 diabetics, usually the starting point is medications that you can take by mouth, but sometimes if those medications aren't enough, they may also need insulin.
I've been doing diabetes for a very long time, and I think currently the therapies available to the diabetic are fantastic.
Metformin is a medication that is commonly used for diabetes. It helps your body to respond better to its own insulin, and it helps your body to produce less glucose, which is a sugar that causes rises in your blood sugar. This is a popular medication because it's effective at treating diabetes and the cost is low. There are some side effects associated with it, like all medications. The most common side effect is GI upset. People commonly experience diarrhea, but this could be avoided when the medication is started at a low dose and slowly increased over time. It also typically gets better over time.
So that's usually our first go-to. But if there are other things going on with you, for example, if you've had a heart attack or you have congestive heart failure, there are specific types of diabetes medications that may be even better for you or maybe additionally needed to treat your diabetes. We now also have medications for diabetes that have been specifically approved for weight loss.
The GLP-1s work by first restoring the signal to your brain that you are full after you eat. So in diabetes, that signal is thought to be not as sensitive as it was before. So the GLP-1 will help you so you won't eat as much because you'll feel full early. Second, the food that you do eat, it slows it down through the stomach and the intestines so the sugar doesn't get absorbed as fast. So your body's able to better manage that increased sugar with its own insulin. Third, in response to the food, the GLP-1 helps you produce insulin to respond to that sugar load.
These medications are injectable, but they're not insulin. And they require, most of them require injections just once a week. So it's a little bit easier to take than, let's say, once daily insulin injections. You're probably wondering, which one is the right one for me? And the right medication for you is gonna be the one that you can take regularly, and the one that gives you the least side effects and that works the best in terms of reducing your blood sugars and your risk of complications.
The biggest advice is you gotta take your medications. Talk to your pharmacist if there's a barrier, maybe that's what they're there for. Maybe they can help you figure out how to manage your medications, taking a different time of the day, combining medications that are not combined. They can help you find strategies on how to take your medications, pill boxes, reminders, apps on your phone, whatever you need. But the important thing is to take your medication.